저그가 만난다. 하지만 이번엔 1세트와 다르다. 모든 선수들을 두려움에 떨게 만든 저그. 그리고 이제는 새로운 기록을 만들어내야 하는 프로토스. 바로 이 두 선수의 승부. 그는 혜성처럼 떠올라 모두를 겁에 질리게 했다. 그리고 그는 김원기, 임재덕과 함께 또 한 명의 저그 강신으로 떠올랐다. 2011 GSL 제뉴얼이 고대의 우승. 최근 10세트 성적 9승 1패에 이르는 승리의 사나이. I am 로시라 황강호. 황강호의 부름을 받은 사나이. 최강의 종족 프로토스. 그리고 최강의 선수가 되기 위해 오늘 반드시 첫 승을 가져가겠다는 이 선수. GSL 전 시즌 출전. 2011 GSL 제뉴얼이 16강. 그리고 GSL 마치 32강. 최근 10세트 성적 5승 5패. MVP 지니어스 정민수. 로시라와 지니어스의 드림 매치. 오랜 시간 함께 연습을 해왔던 두 선수가 승부를 보게 된 2세트 맵은 바로 젤라가 요새. IMMVP 정종현을 코드웨이로 떨어뜨린 정민수. 그리고 오늘 정종현의 복수를 자청한 IM의 돌풍주역 황강호. 상대 종족전에 대한 높은 승률을 가진 두 선수 중 1승을 추가하게 될 선수는 누가 될 것인가. 황강호 대 정민수, 정민수 대 황강호. 과연 모두가 겁낸 저그왕이 승리하게 될 것인가. 아니면 지니어스의 승리 세레머니를 보게 될 것인가. 2011 LG 시네마 3D GSL 메이 C조 2세트. 드디어 두 선수의 전쟁이 시작됐다.
I am Moshira vs. MVP Genius.
Over here in the red, upper left, new up and coming Zerg.
I am Moshira.
And I see Lucira. He knows how to do it, man.
He does.
He's good, man.
He's like a godly Zerg right now.
He is. A little baller Zerg over here.
All right. Now, over here to the center right side of the map.
MVP Genius.
Nah, I think, he loses in that.
Compared to Lucira. He was heads and shoulders above Hongan and Kyrix.
Yeah, Lucira, that was like a 10 out of 10.
It was good, man. I wouldn't give it a 10 out of 10. I would give it a 9, 8 or a 9.
8.9? All right, yeah, true. I shouldn't overrate. Thank you, LG, Intel, and G-Skill for making this event possible. Hey, the Korean voice, I'm going to have to find out about this after the show, but I believe that voice is actually the voice of one of our producers. The Korean producers. In that little intro video.
I thought it was John's voice.
That's exactly what John sounds like in person. So it looks like over here we're going to have, as you can see, people from all over the world. France, Finland, Indonesia, the Czech Republic.
That is amazing, Jesus.
Yeah.
That is all over the place.
It's all over the world. This truly is the global StarCraft II League.
Reminds me of, we
had about a 15 or 20 non-Koreans in here.
We had so many.
It was so packed.
Last Codeste.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, man, it's like a elementary school textbook. You got someone from every single country.
Yeah.
It's very PC in here.
That's right, man. Now, I got to say, I think, this one base build, it's very Next Genius right off the bat. Next Genius, if I remember correctly, it was almost always one basing. So there was maybe one game where he fast expanded against Hydra, and he lost. But I generally associate him as a one base Protoss for the start.
I think of him as a two base myself, not a three base though. But we're gonna have to see how he opens up with this, getting that second gas. In the meantime, Lucir just going for the speed first build, very very safe. Things are going a little bit slow right now. And I gotta ask you, Tasteless. I know that you couldn't get Portal to work, but did you hop on Battle.net at all recently?
Last night I did not. I was in nerd shock from Portal not working. So normally I ladder either before work or after work.
Yeah.
But not this time.
Are you going to go on ladder some after work today?
Oh, are you kidding me, man? That's going to be like, I'm going to show up with a chainsaw wearing another nerd's face, running around, screaming, taking nerds out, cutting them up.
That's pretty brutal. I would not want to face you, Tasteless.
Yeah, you would. You're better than me right now, man. You're so nice to say that right now. You're in much better shape than me. Now, I think the big question is where's the next tech building he's going to make? Is he going to make additional gateways? He seems to really want to get rid of this drone.
Yeah. And, you know, on this map, there's a lot of things you got to look on a map to see what someone's going to want to make. You know, is it a good map for a Forge expansion? Obviously, Next Genius does not feel that way here. It's a pretty wide open choke. It's a good gate, a good map to 4-gate on. It's a good map to 3-gate expand. Is it a map where the third base is super-duper far away? In that case, oftentimes you're going to want to go with a Void Ray before or after the expansion. A lot of things to take into consideration for Protoss for Surge.
I haven't messed around with the Void Ray build, actually, off one base in a while. I usually get the Stargate. I do it after I do the 3-gate expand.
You know, Zergs have gotten just so much better recently at the matchup. That some of these new Roach, or semi-old, but Roach Zergling all-ins off 2-base, the kind of like, it's basically Nestie ZVZ used in ZVP.
Actually, yeah,
so
that's exactly
right
what
now.
It is, yeah.
And
scary.
It's so strong. If you don't have like a Void Ray or like God Force Fields, you just kind of die to it, so.
Well, it's also difficult because it's sometimes in battles like that, if you're using the Void Ray to defend, it's hard to actually get that thing all charged up. In
yeah,
a battle,
you gotta target Roaches.
You gotta target Roaches, but then even sometimes then they end up dying.
Yeah, you kill it with another unit, you gotta be careful. And those sentries gonna go ahead. That's actually so funny. On the screen that we showed there, the beams all went straight out. On my screen, they were crossed. And I was gonna make a Ghostbusters joke, and then I looked over, and they weren't crossed on that. I don't know what's going on. My life is a lie.
I don't know either. Artosis.
My computer's seeing different things in this computer.
You got like the Poltergeist computer, it's like changing stuff in there.
The Poltergeist computer, the Banshee computer.
Have you ever seen the movie Poltergeist? That's actually a scary movie.
Like 100 years ago I saw
it. That is actually a scary movie, man.
Wimp.
No, man.
Well, Hallucination on the way. I love 3 Warp Gate Hallucination builds.
Yeah, I don't really see a point not getting Hallucination.
Yeah. He's zero right now. Oh, my God, Tasteless. He's up to 41 drones. Look at all these spine crawlers he's making. I love this style. You know, he doesn't have to use any larva really on Zerglings. He did get Zergling speed. That's more for scouting and threatening. And he's just making a bunch of spines. So I think most likely we will see Mutalisks here. You know, when you get that many spines, that's oftentimes a giveaway. But it could be an Infestor build. You know, Lucira of Godly Zerg, he can really do whatever he wants. But when you're going for that many spines, oftentimes that's what that's going to mean. We do see a lot of scouting going on with these Hallucinated Phoenixes. Workers killed units. There's so many cool things that Blizzard's putting in this game for example.
I know, I love it.
You
doing
love
a
it as
good
much
job.
As I love it. Well, Tasteless, will it be Infestor or will it be Spire? It is going to be Infestor. Awesome.
And he's going to go and get a Hydra Den. I like all these spine crawlers because as he moves the creep out on the map, he can actually just relocate those. Spine crawlers, they're not like the Sunken Colonies in StarCraft 1. There's actually a lot of interesting stuff you can do. Did we get a shot of that?
Okay, I got to tell you guys so much stuff. All right.
Go.
Basically, he's hiding the infestation pit. It's way down in some place that shouldn't ever be checked. He let the Hydralisk Den. Yeah, see, there it is. The Hydralisk Den was scouted by Hallucination. My God, it gets scouted.
That's going to suck. That thing's not going to be easy to defend.
Yeah, now he knows exactly what's going on, but he canceled the Hydralisk Den. This was like an elaborate trick by Lucira. And this is just so interesting, Tasteless.
Well, you know, think about playing against somebody like Genius. As Genius, I mean, he actually does stay true to his name. He actually is, I think, one of the smarter Protosses out there.
He's like one of the originals.
Yeah, he's one of the originals.
He's like the original 6 Warp Gate after Expander.
He's the OG nerd. And I think when you take that into consideration, you're going to have to play pretty intelligently against him because if there's somebody who's going to react properly to your style of play, it's probably going to be Genius. Mm.
Now, I'm getting scared for Genius, though, man, because the Infestor Energy upgrade is almost done. 6 Infestors on the way. That's 6 Fungal Growths, and that is more than enough to kill the entire army of Genius. All these sentries he spent so much money on, so much time getting, you can just kill those with fungals.
Are you reading this as a rush? He's just going to walk up there and fungal everything? Or do you think he's going to wait and try to take the map?
I think he's going to just play a controlling style. You know, he's just going to macro up. He's already got a ton of drones because he bought so many spine crawlers. 60 drones to 59 probes, and he's taking that third base right now. And I feel like he can just control the game from here. You know, he's got all these infestors already. This is actually such a beautiful strategy because with all those spine crawlers, he can get infestors right away. He doesn't have to go rogue. And that's going to give him so many infestors so early. He's even getting Neural Parasite at this point. He's getting his Overlord speed. He's upgrading just all sorts of stuff, getting so many drones, so many more hatches. What really can Genius do from here? This is, it's so interesting. I haven't seen exactly this way to go infestors yet in Zerg versus Protoss.
You know what's interesting about the positioning of the infestation pit is, you know, I was just thinking about it. I guess unless you had a few stalkers in the blink, you actually are not going to be able to get over there and kill that at all.
Yeah.
Because the Zerg can just go into your one and only expansion and kill it and be like, LOL, I just made an infestation pit at home.
Yeah.
LOL.
Well, now we're going to see a light contain, maybe even a little bit of aggression poking there with fungals.
He's going to just do a little fungal harass.
Just start killing stuff. And watch, he's going to time that out, walk back in, give another fungal. Bam, and look at that. A ton of damage being done. Already some of the sentries being taken out. And Genius, I think, is at a loss for words, or at least for what to do here. You know, having infestors out this quick, I feel like without feedback, how are you going to make this work out, man? How are you going to actually go out and kill this army? Look at his army. It's all these armored units that are going to take 47 damage from these fungals.
Well, you know, I think
it's pretty deadly.
If you know this is coming, you got to get Templars right away so you can feedback the, you know, the infestors or do something, but Colossus is not going to do it.
Nice flank up, targeting down some infestors. That's the first step. First step to dealing with those infestors is admitting they're a problem and blinking in and killing some.
It's a simple three-step procedure, really. Right-click move, click on infestor to kill, run away.
He has softened up the Protoss army reasonably well so far, and his economy is pretty wild. He's getting Baneling speed, that plus two melee tech, 76 drones right now, and Lucira basically, this build has been just so brilliant, so awesome, because he has forced his way into a huge economy and a huge amount of tech. Now he can begin his macro. It's so cool, Tasteless. Drops on the way for his Banelings, and Genius playing a really cool counter to this, getting a lot of cannons and taking a third base. Nice fungal growth right there. Got to be careful about those stalkers blinking in and targeting these down.
He's got to be very careful.
Another fungal.
And those stalkers say, go fungal yourself. So, he's continuing to poke across the map here. Just going to take out these, well, you know, I guess he could just actually attack the spine crawlers if he really wanted to. But that would, of course, make those,
oh my god, Jesus.
Come out here.
Oh, 40 Banes are morphing right now.
We'll get a shot of that in a minute, guys. 40 Banelings.
Oh my god, this
that
is such a beautiful build.
Because if you have
watched
fungal, they can't run away.
That's right, and he only has a few sentries left because of all those early fungals killing some. He has three sentries left. Yeah, they have full energy, but you just fungal a few times, and these Banelings are going to finish everything up, Caseless. This is going to be pretty brutal, I think. Oh my god, he better blink away, and he does blink very smartly. Stealing!
Oh!
Colossi! Oh, this is just beautiful play.
Oh my god, this is so impressive. And now he has two Colossi, and there's really no way to actually get to that. Oh, no, he's wrong. He's blink.
Still has.
What am I talking about?
Several Colossi sitting there. And here's the thing. Lucira should have dealt with those Colossi a little bit quicker, I feel. You know, made them target each other, kill them off ASAP, because now there's two more Colossi there than there really should be. And now Lucira is going to be in a much harder position.
All right, more. Oh, my God. So many more Banelings.
So many more. And he does have two fungals ready from these infestors. Another one will be ready pretty soon. And now it's three base versus three base. So Genius is doing a good job, but I really do feel like Lucira didn't make the right decisions that last battle. He definitely had enough to take out that army, but he did not get to do that. A lot of Zerglings being killed off by a nice blink.
Yeah.
By the way, upgrades plus two to attacks for Genius, plus two to melee attacks for Lucira. A lot of Zerglings and Infestors on the way. Basically just going Zergling, Baneling, Infestor. And here
this
we go.
This is enough Colossi to maybe just tear down this expansion. That doesn't seem like Lucira's actually equipped to deal with this.
And that is going to be taken out. Lucira now suddenly in a very bad position, but he does have a Baneling drop coming towards the expansion of Genius.
That was actually pretty sexy. Canceled out. Right.
At the natural.
At the natural. We need a shot
Genius
of the natural
at
expansion.
Expansion.
The natural expansion.
There we go. Nice Baneling drops. Wow. And those Banelings are doing sick damage, Tasteless.
Uh-oh. But does it matter if Zerg loses his main base or not? He's going to go back out here.
And he's going to want to fungal, but instead choosing some Neurals. That's going to slow down everything from killing his Banelings off. A lot of them trapped behind Force Field still.
The sheer number of Zerg units.
But here's the thing. Neural runs out, Tasteless, and now those Colossi are going to start dealing a lot more damage.
There was a drone there for some reason, a little bit too ambitious. And I don't know, man. I think that's going to be it. Yeah, GG.
This was one of the most interesting games that I have ever seen, Tasteless. And it seemed a little bit anticlimactic. Oh, look at that. That guy.
I love that guy.
Such an interesting.
He's got some attitude.
He does. Now, let me just say real quick about what we just saw. Lucira's strategy was almost a god strategy. Almost, oh my god, this
brilliant.
Is unbelievably good. But it just, it's a little bit off. It's a little bit off, Tasteless.
We've got a comic here. This is actually going to fast press and follow.
That's pretty awesome.
That's basically right. What our toast looks like without a shirt on.
I think that Lucira, his decisions in those battles could have been changed just slightly, and the game could have gone very differently. So that's my take on that.
Well, it's interestingly
enough. Owl, Owl, Illwall.
We got Hagen and Lucira not doing well. The people I actually predicted for the Koreans they play XP.
Yeah.
Give us predictions for them.
Yeah, yeah.
I actually predicted that Lucira and Genius were going to get out of this group.
Oh, really? I put Lucira and Hongan barely. I was like a close one.
Well, here we are.
This is just that strategy was so interesting. That has so much
that
potential.
That strategy was pretty
because I know there's a lot of Zergs out there crying some Zerg tears and look, even after that Genius play, he lost. Well,
the Kerrigan will never marry me.
I think that Lucira really messed that up a little bit. I think that that the way he played that has so much potential up until the battles.
Yeah, I think so.
The battles just did not go right.
All right, we're going to have a 2-minute break, so don't go too far away. This is the GSL.